Over 10,000 websites are blocked in China. No Instagram scrolling, no WhatsApp messaging, and forget Googling how to bypass internet censorship, that's blocked too. But the Great Firewall isn't unbreakable. And today, I'll show you 4 tested ways to access the open internet in China without getting caught. First, let's talk about why it's so hard to penetrate China's Great Firewall. The Great Firewall is one of the most advanced digital barriers in the world. It actively tracks, filters, and shuts down anything that slips through. Most VPNs, blocked. Proxies, blocked. Even certain words in search queries, completely erased. And the worst part? It's constantly evolving. AI-powered filters, deep packet inspection, and aggressive takedowns means that what worked yesterday might be useless today. This isn't about a simple block list. It's real-time censorship that adapts fast. And if you think that you can just Google a quick fix while you're in China, well, joke's on you because Google itself is blocked. The good news? The Great Firewall has its weaknesses. All right, so you know China blocks content left and right, but how exactly does that affect you? Well, first, it's not just social media. It's your entire digital life. Google, gone. WhatsApp, unreliable. Even cloud services like Dropbox and Google Drive don't work properly. So if you need to send an email, get directions, or access work files, good luck. And here's the real problem. It's not just about blocking websites. The Great Firewall tracks, filters, and adapts in real time, which means tools that worked last month might be useless today. And that's why I made this video. You need solutions that actually work right now in 2025. No outdated tricks, no unreliable hacks. I've got 4 tested methods that will keep you connected while you're in China. By the end, you'll have a clear plan for staying online no matter how strict China's censorship gets. So now that you know why China's censorship is so locked down, let's talk about how to get around it. Method number 1 is to use a VPN, which is definitely the most reliable option. The easiest way to get around China's internet restrictions is with a VPN. A virtual private network, or VPN, encrypts your data and routes it through a server outside of China, making it look like you're browsing from somewhere else. In theory, that should give you full access to the open internet. But here's the catch. China knows this and actively fights back. The Great Firewall detects and blocks most VPN traffic using deep packet inspection. Free VPNs, completely useless. Even a lot of paid ones don't stand a chance. To actually work in China, a VPN needs obfuscation technology, which makes VPN traffic look like regular internet activity. Without it, you'll just get connection errors. Right now, one of the most reliable VPNs in China is ExpressVPN. It updates its servers constantly to stay ahead of the blocks, delivers fast speeds, and works on multiple devices. But you need to install it before you arrive in China. VPN websites are blocked in China, so if you don't have one set up beforehand, then downloading one becomes a headache, if not impossible. So here's how to use a VPN in China successfully. First, install it before you arrive. VPN websites are blocked once you're in China, so you will also want to have a backup VPN just in case. Even the best ones can temporarily get blocked, so keep it updated. VPNs that work today might get blocked tomorrow, so check for updates. A VPN is still the best way to access blocked sites in China, but it's not the only option. Method 2 is using Tor, the privacy-first option. If your VPN isn't working or you want extra anonymity, there's another option, which is Tor. Tor stands for the Onion Router, and yeah, the name is fitting. It layers your data in multiple levels of encryption and sends it through different relays all around the world. Instead of a direct connection, your traffic bounces through multiple random locations, making it nearly impossible to track. Sounds great, right? Well, not exactly. Downloading Tor in China is a nightmare, as you can imagine. The official Tor website is blocked, so if you didn't install it before you arrived, then you're out of luck. Unless you email gettor@torproject.org for an alternate download link. And even if you do get it, using Tor is painfully slow. Your data hops between multiple encrypted relays, so expect pages to take forever to load. And you can completely forget about streaming, video calls, or anything requiring real speed. And then there's China's censorship itself. The government actively blocks standard Tor connections, meaning you can't just install and start browsing. You'll need Tor bridges, which are unlisted connection points that help you sneak past the firewall. First, again, install it before you get there. If you're already in China, your only chance is getting a download link via email. Next, you need Tor bridges, alternative relays that help disguise your connection. The These aren't enabled by default, so you have to request them in advance. And finally, for an extra layer of security, run Tor over a VPN. This hides the fact that you're using Tor in the first place, making it even harder for a firewall to block you. Tor is great for privacy, but it's far from perfect for daily use. Method 3 is Ultrasurf, the quick and free option. If VPNs are too risky and Tor is too slow, there's another option, which is Ultrasurf. Originally built to help internet users in China bypass censorship, Ultrasurf is a free, lightweight proxy tool that lets you access blocked websites without installing a full VPN. It connects you through an encrypted tunnel to its network of constantly changing servers, making it harder for the Great Firewall to block. But before you get too excited, there are some trade-offs here as well. Ultrasurf is nowhere near as secure as a VPN. It only encrypts your browser traffic, meaning everything else, your apps, emails, and background connections, all are still exposed. It's also not as stable. Unlike a premium VPN, which offers dedicated servers, Ultrasurf constantly shifts between IP addresses, so your connection might drop at any time. And then there's speed. It works, but don't expect it to be lightning fast, especially during peak hours. Using Ultrasurf in China is actually pretty simple. Download Ultrasurf, open it, and connect. There's no account setup, no configuration, just click and go. If one connection doesn't work, it automatically switches to another server until it finds one that does. That's also what makes it useful as a backup option as well. If your VPN stops working or you need a quick way to access blocked sites, Ultrasurf is a decent fallback. It's not a long-term solution, but for something fast, free, and easy, it definitely gets the job done. Method 4 is known as Shadowsocks, the stealthy proxy option. If you're looking for something faster than Tor and more stable than Ultrasurf, there is Shadowsocks. Originally developed by a Chinese programmer to bypass the Great Firewall, Shadowsocks is an encrypted proxy that disguises your internet traffic as normal HTTPS activity. Unlike VPNs, which route all of your data through an external server, Shadowsocks only encrypts specific traffic, making it harder to detect and block. But while Shadowsocks is great for getting around censorship, it's not a full privacy tool. It doesn't completely hide your IP address like a VPN does, and it's not built for anonymity. It's designed to blend in, not to disappear. To use Shadowsocks in China, you'll need to set it up manually. First, you'll need to access a Shadowsocks server, which means either renting one or setting it up on your own outside of China. Then you'll configure the Shadowsocks client on your device to connect through that server. It's a bit more technical than a VPN or plug-and-play tools like Ultrasurf, but once it's set up, it's one of the most effective and low-profile ways to access the open internet in China. If you're tech-savvy and want a stealthy, reliable solution, Shadowsocks is a solid choice. But if you're looking for something easier to use, a VPN is still your best bet. So now that we've gone through all four methods, let's wrap this up. If you're in China and you need to access blocked sites, you have four solid options. VPNs are the best all-around solution, but only if you use one that works in China and install it before you arrive. Tor is great for privacy, but slow and difficult to set up if you're already in China. Ultrasurf is a great free, easy-to-use backup tool, but it's not as secure or stable as a VPN. And Shadowsocks is a stealthy proxy that works well, but requires manual setup and isn't a fully private tool. Each method has its pros and cons, and the best approach, well, have a backup plan. If one method stops working, you'll need another way to stay connected. If you found this video to be helpful, be sure to hit that like button. It really does help us out. And if you want more cybersecurity tips and privacy tricks, then subscribe and turn on notifications so you don't miss our next video. That's all for today's video, but stay safe online, and we'll see you in the next one.